I've got a huge amount of experience sort of adventure cycling, so I've, you know, cycled in all sorts of conditions. So I mean, I've got the confidence that I can ride through deserts, I can ride through incredible sort of headwinds and, you know, tough conditions. But never before have I had the ability in Scotland to start my adaptation process before I hit the road. So, you know, it's fantastic having, you know, these resources at Napier and the support of Lesley, because there's no other way to me sort of fast track that preparation. You know, like a lot of athletes, I've got a busy family life, I've got kids, I've got quite an event schedule, you know, work schedule out with training. So having a real structure and having somebody else tell me what to do, make sure that the training remains the priority. It doesn't get pushed down the priority list. But also to make sure I actually don't overtrain. You know, the temptation as an ultra endurance athlete is to always feel like you need to do more, you know, just to ride, you know, ride and ride and ride. So having the discipline to say, do you know what, I've done enough. And, you know, the recovery, the sleep patterns, everything else which complements training hard is something that it takes somebody else to set. You know, you need a bit of objectivity, because if it was just left to me, you know, I would just grab every spare moment. You know, I'm famous for getting up at 4 or 5 in the morning and just getting on the watt bike and doing horrible sessions. So, you know, having somebody else saying, no, you've done enough, or, you know, or you need to do more intensity, or you need to switch it up to make sure you've got enough all-round conditioning, that takes somebody else, because otherwise I would just go out and ride my bike.